لمهاقمها غرقا استرهاننا
The Tuaregs, who count in millions in the great desert, live in Libya, Niger, Mali, Algeria, and all the way west to Mauritania. They are not nomads and have of old settled in this area. They do not recognize borders and move freely across frontiers. Nevertheless, the majority of the Tuaregs were denied Libyan citizenship, although Libya's area is by no means too small to host them. Their relationship to the colonel has always been close. He relies on them and they are loyal to him. They even helped him in some of his military foreign adventures, both in Lebanon and Chad.
الطوارق طبعا هناك جزء من الطوارق موجود في ليبيا وهم جزء اصيل من السكان الليبيين.
Some of the Tuaregs live in Libya and are part and parcel of Libya's indigenous population. Gaddafi has used many of them in his forces. Officially documented information we possess.
أكيد والرسمية التي لدينا أن منح الجنسية الليبية ل
shows that he granted citizenships to around 20,000 of them. They joined his special regiments and military apparatus.
كتائبه الأمنية وأجهزته الأمنية.
I came here to Gat in 1951. Please be our guest. You are our guest.
These people have no real income except benefiting from their remote location and smuggling everything from weapons to people. Only they and their camels know every pebble of sand and drop of water in this vast, mysterious desert. They may have lost their wealth, but not their culture. It is all they have, along with their tents and modest dwellings. Wars taking place in northern Libya do not relate to these people in one way or another, except in as much as their fighters took part in supporting the colonel. Natural, ethnic, and class differences loom large. There are no clear real ties between the North and the South. Nevertheless, they are the ones who defend the frontier or may abandon it.
Libya is a vast country. I don't think anyone immigrating to Libya who has tribal ties will face refusal to his presence. But those minorities with no ties inside Libya will no doubt face some reaction, considering that they were repatriated only for political purposes with the aim of protecting the regime.
وربما منح الجنسية لها لأغراض سياسية صرفة لحماية النظام.
لابد من استيعاب أن
One has to remember that Libya is a homeland. It is multi-regional.
له تعدد جهوي.
Something that is normal in every country, including the United States and in Europe.
المتحدة في أوروبا.
What remained of this castle in Ghat was once a military fort used by the Ottoman army. This is the last of the roads to be seen for hundreds of kilometers of the valleys and heights void of everything but legends. Desert and rocks keep secrets of people from thousands of years ago.
ميم وصوارتي لله
Glory traces may not be evident in this spot of the region of Fezzan in southwestern Libya, but by moving further deep into the desert, the visitor discovers that its history may not be much different from the planet Mars. Scientists say that Mars had known rivers. Some have remained frozen until today. Nature here is very similar to the pictures that have reached us from Mars, with all its lore. Rocks and sand, dry winds, hot and cold, whistle through mountain ridges. The inhabitants say that some of them encountered fairies in the Akakus Mountains, fairies that have haunted heroes of the novels of Ibrahim al-Kuni, the Libyan international author whose Arabic literature has been translated into 70 languages. The messages of Mars have been passed down to the majority of the inhabitants of the Earth. However, the messages of the caves and rocks of the earthly Akakus Mountains have not reached us in full. Before 14,000 years, there were no pens or paper. This is an age put by archaeologists of the rock art, which was inscribed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site since 1985.
Look, the color here is different. This is spotted. This one is suckling. Look at the shepherds. They have dogs with them. Here under, it used to be full, but unfortunately, all is gone. Gone.
These rocks arts carry a strong warning message against desertification. They say yes, this area knew vegetation that animals such as giraffes, cows, elephants, and ostriches lived on. They portrayed the humans and their weapons, showed humans enjoying music and dancing to it. These rare treasures that will outlast oil reserves were left to be tampered with by people coming across from every border without protection, prevention, or awareness. The rock arts are supposed to be protected by bars. Even flashlights are not supposed to be used in taking pictures of them.
A cultural reserve should be established here. This area should be protected in full by closing all the roads leading to Akakus Imsak. They are numbered. Access to the area should be allowed only by official permits. Colonel's background is backward. Therefore, I do not think that he had any feelings towards the value of the treasures in the country, whether they are historical places or any kind of resources.
Shashu Gihrwan.
History is frozen here in the misery of this Twarqi family. Yet it inspires the Minister of Tourism to take a picture with the hot Twarqi lady. But she refuses to do that for a smile and demands payment. Money is more important to her than his compliments. This Twarqi man was successful to hire his camel out for a while. If there were touristic amenities in this spot of the desert, they would have stayed here and revived it. However, they pass by or may stay here overnight in a tent that they carry on with them.
It is extremely important to develop touristic facilities in this area, although some tourists prefer that it remains as it is without big developments. But these are people of mid-range income. Richer tourists need comfortable amenities to stay in after an exhaustive traveling in an area spanning 500 kilometers.
The next stop after Ghat and the Akakus mountain ranges is Jerma. The capital of the Germans was discovered in the 7th century AD beneath the Islamic Jerma, which carries the same name. Jerma used to be a thriving stop for the caravan trader when it was conquered by the Muslims. Some of the burials in Jerma take the shape of pyramids like the Hatiya pyramids here. Here lies a private, somehow modern hotel, a museum rich with antiquities, some dating back to 7,000 years. This mummy, dating back to 2,300 years ago, was discovered by a German team of scientists in the late 1960s.
The authority of antiquities faces a daunting task. The heritage is tremendous. Libya is extremely vast. It is almost a continent. The antiquities are scattered in distant areas, sometimes almost impossible to reach.
The features and cultures of the people of the capital of the Germans here in midwestern Libya is totally different from what we have seen in the south. So are their cultures and music.
It is needless to say that the Libyans are united by language, same faith and sect. Also, in many cases, their tribes are mixed, that it is difficult to distinguish persons if they were from this or that tribe. Tribalism has, of course, totally disappeared from the western area.
No desert trip in Libya is complete without visiting the wonders of Qabr Aun, the lakes located in Wadi al-Hayat, meaning Valley of Life. The journey starts from Takarkiba, where the tires' pressure should be released in order to avoid sinking in the soft sand. Only four-wheel drive vehicles can climb these lofty dunes. Equally, only brave and skilled drivers manage to do this job. They will have to cross 60 kilometers on these dunes in order to reach the lakes. Yet it is great fun for adventure seekers.
With the ups and downs of these wavy dunes, international motor races can be organized to take place in this area.
The lake water is very salty. Only Dead Sea water beats its salinity. Nevertheless, it is surrounded by different types of plants and palm trees. Also, no one has been known to have drowned here, although the water is 7 meters deep. If this is not strange enough, all the violent sandstorms that hit the high dunes never narrowed or increased the size of these lakes. Tourists in the tens of thousands visit this place every year. They watch the beautiful views and enjoy climbing the dunes by car or on foot. Some practice dune surfing like they do in Algeria. Others come to draw and contemplate these heavenly miracles. However, with all this beauty, tourists do not find more than a makeshift restaurant in the area. To find the nearest hotel, you need to travel a minimum of 60 kilometers. Staying overnight in a tent in this spot is not possible because of the desert mosquitoes, which fiercely defend their territory.